ってサボってたんだよ。
すいません。
口答えしてんじゃねえよ。謝る暇だ。予算表出せ。ほら予算表、予算表、予算表。ほら
会社が超ブラックってやつだ。
Hey everyone, Rascal here.
And Mama, welcome to our Paws On Animation channel.
And today we're covering the live action version of Zom 100, Bucklist of the Dead. Yes, there is actually a live action of this.
Yes, and this is the Netflix exclusive movie that premiered the same day as the anime. And it's a retelling of the first season's events, or at least the first half of it. And surprise, surprise, it stinks!
Before we start, be sure to like, subscribe, and click the notification bell on future podcasts and World of Paws videos.
And thank you for joining us and for your support and subscribing. We appreciate it so much.
Yeah.
So if you're like us, you saw the Zom 100 anime, Bucket List of the Dead, back in October?
I think so, yeah. Or September, because it didn't finish all the way until December, with the last three seasons.
Right, it aired for some reason in July. It didn't make any sense in 2023. And then finished December 26th.
Right, it's like, yeah, no.
So if you're not familiar, it's a comedy horror, and definitely a comedy, dystopian zombie apocalypse, original manga written by Haruo Aso, illustrated by Kotaro Takada, and then the anime was directed by Kazuki Kawago, and the live-action film is directed by Yusuke Ishida. Mm-hmm. So you've got all these different people working on it.
Yes, so, like we said, this movie came out the exact same time as the anime. I guess it'd be a sort of double feature for the ones who were watching. And yes, much like some of their other dives into live action anime minus One Piece, it's terrible. And we say that because one of the biggest, most crucial things that made the Zom 100 anime stand out is that it was, if TWD was a comedy, that's pretty much the big basis of it. TWD was a comedy instead of all out horror and drama and betrayal and all that. You still got them running from the zombies, but it's with an optimistic point of view, and you're laughing, having a good time. They even have the zombies do some really silly things, so you're not seeing the depravity as much. You just right. know it's still serious. Until they start biting people, it's hilarious, and you just gotta get away. The problem with this movie, it tones down the comedy so much, it actually ends up being more of a drama and introspective on everyone's character and how they treat each other.
And it's not very positive. Also, if you've seen the anime, you know that there was no blood spatter in red. It was all these neon colors.
Yeah, like paintball.
Well, they didn't do that for the live-action movie.
Yeah, it just went straight up to blood. No paintball splatter, just flat-out red.
So who made this decision? Well, the screenplay was written by Tatsuro Mishima. Akira Mori served as the producer, who's at Robot Communications, and they did this in collaboration with Plus One Entertainment. And they should have just stuck with the anime. We were expecting it to be fun. It wasn't. And we really expected it to be dubbed with Zeno Robinson,
yes,
and Xander Mobus, and
it's
all
completely
these
different.
We wanted to see. But no, they couldn't do that.
No, it's completely different people. I think the only time they got the original people is when they got Johnny Young Bosch for Bleach and no one else. And then the main trio for Full Metal Alchemist until later, and they just only got the main first two, and that was it.
And then another thing that really was didn't make sense is a lot of the characters that were intricate in making the anime good, they just got rid of.
Yeah.
Including the blonde Swedish woman, she didn't exist.
No, she's completely gone from here.
A lot of the airline stewardesses and the men.
Yeah,
they weren't there.
Yeah, they were there, but they were, their roles were a little different. They were a little bit different characters.
They didn't have the importance in the anime in this movie. But there were a lot of characters. I'll just say that. I won't try to name them all. But they were not in the live action movie.
No.
And one thing is Akira was a thief in here. Unlike in the anime where he went to the store and he only took the things he needed.
And
Akira went
beer.
On a shopping spree, and he was excited, and he was just taking everything like, he didn't need.
Yeah, he had a basket full of food and stuff that wasn't just essential. It was just junk food and things. The only thing he kind of got was a treat for himself in the anime was beer. He really wanted a beer. Well, that's it.
That's what he originally went for, was beer.
Yeah.
And then he got a couple other things that he loved.
And this he got some things for his neighbors,
this
too.
This guy got a basket and just, might as well say he rioted and plundered the store and took everything. He was like, what are you doing?
Yeah. And another thing
and
is
I guess
that...
I said, well, this would be more realistic. Well, maybe in the world they've written. Yeah. But to me, it seemed like Akira's look at it was better. Not just because he was a nice guy and he thought of things, but because he didn't seem to be a person who would take more than he needed. Mm-hmm. He asked the neighbors, could he get them something? And he got what they needed. But he didn't go there and just take everything in the store and went on the street riding in the basket, acting like a nutcase, and stealing.
Yeah.
He didn't do that. And I guess... they thought this would be funny, but it wasn't because of seeing the anime. It's like, why would they change his character?
And another thing is that he doesn't really get along with people as well as in the anime, too. Because the movie covers, like we said, the first half of the first season. It covers up all the way up to where they end up finding out his boss did not get zombified and he's running a pretty much a slave labor type workplace all over again, just with zombies at it and nothing changed for the guy. That's where the story pretty much ends with this movie. And as it gets to that point, Akira's interaction with people is not positive. He seems positive and he's really happy, but he's really crazy happy. His relationship with his best friend, it was more on to the point in here where he was kind of a jerk and so was his friend. They had a falling out and didn't speak to each other anymore. Before, it was just sort of like work stress getting to him, and that's why he lashed out and didn't mean it, which is why when he cries, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to say that to you, and him losing it. Here, it's just that they both had disagreements, they butted heads, and they pretty much ended their friendship until he found him again, which was really different from the anime and possibly the manga. It's like he really wasn't close with anybody in this version. He had to get close to them as it went on.
And it was almost like they said, well, we want to make it more reflective of how we think society is. And Kencho was a whole different character.
Oh, yeah.
He wasn't this friendly, outgoing character that he became that way again after Akira came to save him. Before that, he was miserable.
Yeah.
And he told him. But after they were together again, they were buddies again, they were bros. Not in here. He's a whole different character, and Kencho is not likable at all in this movie.
Of course, they couldn't have him stripped down in here. Like, okay, we get that, understand. But he's kind of an ass. I'm sorry. They get to that part where, they drink with the stewardess and the guy that were hiding out from the zombies when they're hiding out. And they really wanted to hammer the fact that Akira's a big loser because the guy took actually both women and they implied he was just gonna go do the thing with both of them at the same time. It's like, oh, so he's just despicable in here. And that kind of pissed me off because it's like, you're kind of horrible in here. First, you're just like, okay, look how he looks. Of course, get the win. But no, they had to rub it salt in the moon like you're such a fat, big fat loser that this guy's going to take both girls. You're not going to get either one of them. It was just really tasteless. And there's a lot of tasteless jokes in here at the expense of the message and humor is Akira's a loser. That's the whole joke. Akira is a loser is the entire joke of the movie, and we weren't laughing after the first time.
And then one of the best jokes in the anime is when they went to this aquarium and they thought they were safe and just looking at the fish, and all of a sudden there's a shark in the tank with legs because he's eaten three people.
Yeah.
And they ran and the shark chased them.
Yeah, with
the
legs.
Well, in the anime it was hilarious. It's nothing you've seen done. It might have lasted 2 minutes at the most.
Yeah.
Well, in here they made the stupid scene last 20 minutes. It got ridiculous.
It was the climax of the movie.
The shark, and the shark was trying to eat people.
Yeah, it was a
big... And they were screaming and running.
And
then Akira sacrificed himself. Like, what the heck are you doing here?
Oh.
This is stupid.
Yeah. That's definitely something we gotta get to. They only meet him and the girl. They end up traveling together, and they kind of rush through all the things on the list. By the way, Akira wanting to go see his parents again is not on the list. He's doing whatever he wants.
It ended right after this stupid scene that I just told you about. And they go to the RV.
Yeah.
And they said they're going to go.
They never wrote it down.
They're just going to go.
That's
it. We're like, what?
Yeah.
That's the end of the movie.
Yeah. And that's what we saw at the beginning of the season. The end of the season would be him getting to his parents and checking on, make sure they're okay. In here, his parents are never brought up. Not we thought at some point in the movie, halfway through, they would bring it up. They never do. As you said, the movie's finale takes place and they combine the aquarium episode and meeting his old boss again episode combined with the climax. This time, instead of the boss being in the middle of a parking lot and deserted, he is at the aquarium with a bunch of people with enough to make a small town, and yet again still having them work under his thumb with the zombies included, and immediately gets Akira convinced to work for him again because, well, you don't need them anymore. You could just work for me and they can go after your car is fixed. They don't even have to stay here. You just gotta work for me. And Akira just rolls over and does it. Not with the resistance he had in the anime where he was terrified of going back to that. He just rolls over and does it. They bring up as stupid, but they just do it anyway. And the whole movie, as Mama brought up, is the shark chasing everybody for 20 minutes straight. And it's lasts so long, you start getting bored of it. By the time you're 10 minutes in, you're waiting for the thing to end.
And it lasts literally 20 minutes.
We counted,
it was
yes.
The dumbest things they did, and how it ended was stupid. That it just, this movie is bad. There's no nice way to put it. And we don't like to dog movies, but don't waste your time on live action Zom 100. Invest all of your time in the anime. The anime is spectacular. It's fun. The dub is fantastic. The Japanese sub is, the English sub, Japanese is fantastic. Either way you watch the anime, you're going to love it. But Zeno Robinson is fantastic as Akira.
Yeah.
So watch it both ways. You're going to love it both ways. And invest your time in watching it that way. That's what we recommend.
Yeah.
Don't waste 1 minute on watching this live action. This was a waste of money. A waste of time.
Why?
A waste of an hour, 2 hours actually.
Yeah.
That you can't get back. And I would not recommend this even as a joke.
No.
There's no joy, no fun. It should have never been made.
Right. And worst of all, they put this out at the same time as the anime, thinking this will get people to watch it without judging the anime. We're judging with the anime first. That didn't work out because we all watched the anime first anyway.
Absolutely. So if you've seen Zom 100, Bucket List of the Dead, live action movie, and I really hope you haven't, let us know what you think in the comments. Do you think it sucked like we did, or did you like it? Did you like that it was more dystopian and not humorous like the anime?
Mm.
Or do you prefer the anime? Let us know what you think. If you haven't seen it, don't waste your time. Go watch Train to Busan or something else fantastic. Or even, as we were saying, The Walking Dead. Rerun.
Yeah.
Go watch anything but this live action movie.
And if you haven't already, subscribe for updates of your viewers' favorite anime series, anime shows, and all things animation.
Yes.
And sometimes live action.
And be sure to share this video to let others not to waste their time on watching this movie.
Yes.
It really helps
spread
our
the
channel,
word.
And we really appreciate it.
Yes, spread the word. Thank you so much for watching. Rascal Entertainment.
And I'm Mom Entertainment.
Have a toontastic day.
Peace.